waiting for a moment, because I have to do something.
Yes.
No music. Well, there is some music, yes, but I rather doubt it. Now, I made a promise, and I keep my promises, but I... You'll have to wait, because I've got to get the props ready first.
Oh,
now, it just so happens that when I played the narrator 3 years ago, I didn't wear glasses. Now I wear them for real. And by chance, they happen to be exactly the same ones. The half moon, which you will see in a moment. So I made it on these glasses. Now, I want you to imagine that... by the way, is there a gentleman who had a film script I talked to earlier? Ah. Approach me.
You want the title?
Yes. What I like is a feed-in. Now, can you play Columbia, Magenta, and Riff Raff in your... You could do Riff. All right, then. No, I'm only half serious. Now, can you sing? Because I can't.
No.
Right, that's two of us. Well, I mean, you can attempt to sing, can't you? I mean, if I can attempt to sing, surely you can.
Yeah.
Right. Now, I want you to go from It's Amazing, you know, the beginning of the time war? You see what's happening? Astounding. I beg your pudding. Incidentally, someone's commented on the fan I'm using. I think I'll tell you before I go any further that there was a dinner just before Christmas in London, which John Pertwee, Douglas Campfield, John Levine and myself attended. And John Levine presented me with this fan at Christmas time. Now, I haven't worked out why yet, but it's very, very useful here. And this is the fan that John Levine presented. So I'm using it. And I'm still waiting for that mint julep. In the absence of that, Californian rosé wine will do frightfully well. Now, you are ready when I tell you, yes?
Yeah.
Good. Because I'm going to appear from there, which is where I used to appear, you see. Now, what you must understand is that when I play the narrator for the second time, the director, Neil McCall, we were rehearsing, you know, and one director directed the first tour, then Neil McCall directed it, and he gave me a note. He said, yes, I like the professorial touch. So that's why I've got the glasses. That's what my performance may be like, if I can remember the lines. And so, here we go. Now, wait a minute. I'm glad there's a mic here, because it's exactly reproduction of what happened. Exact. About exact. So, on cue you.
It's astounding. Time is fleeting. Madness takes its toll. But listen closely, not for very much longer. I've got to keep control. I remember doing the time warp, drinking those moments when the blackness would hit me and the voice would be calling. Let's do the time warp again. Let's do the time.
My first line, I forgot it. Finish up the script.
It's a jump of blood.
It's what?
It's a jump of blood.
Oh, I'll do it again. Cue again. Give me a couple lines.
Last 2 lines, let's do the time warp again.
Let's do the time warp again. Let's do the time warp again.
What was the line I had to say again? This, I'm gonna make you wait. What was my line?
It's just a jump to the left.
Thank you. 2 lines, once more.
Let's do the time warp again. Let's do the time warp again.
It's just a jump to the left.
And a step to the right.
What?
Cruise.